The naming of secretaries and principal secretaries is an urgent step in the implementation of the new structure of government, a process that is crucial to this year's budget making. The budget making process has stalled because of the changed structure of the government. For instance, the Ministry of Agriculture cannot give its proposals since it will now incorporate all the related ministries that were operating independently. The formation of the Parliamentary Committee on Appointments is eagerly awaited in order to pave the way for the vetting of cabinet secretaries and principal secretaries. The majority leader in the National Assembly, Aden Duale, says the coalition's list is ready and will be presented to the House Business Committee on Tuesday morning. CORD Deputy Minority Leader Jakoyo Midiwo also says the coalition's list is in final stages and it is being crafted alongside the coalition's members to other committees in the House. The names will first be presented to an extraordinary meeting of the House Business Committee that sets the business of the House on Tuesday morning before being tabled in the House same day in the afternoon. The formation of the committee will then pave way for vetting of cabinet secretaries and principal secretaries. The speaker, upon receiving nominees for those public appointments from the president, will forward their names to the committee on appointments. There will be a period of 7 days for members of public to participate in the process. But for now, the proposed names for the 28-member parliamentary committee on appointments are yet to be known.
What we know so far is that those who will be members of the committee by virtue of their offices are the Speaker and his deputy, the Majority Leader Aden Duale of Jubilee, his deputy Dr. Naomi Shaban, the Minority Leader Francis Nyenze of CORD and his deputy Jakoyo Midiwo. Apart from cabinet secretaries, the other positions that will require vetting are principal secretaries who are formerly known as permanent secretaries, ambassadors, high commissioners, and any other state or public officer whom the constitution empowers the president to appoint or dismiss. Alex Chamwada for Citizen Weekend.